quick bit just to explain how I use the effects on an EMU sampler. Essentially all I'm doing is using the two main outputs on the back of the sampler. I'm not using a mixer or anything, so I need to be able to use the two little effects units in there for each preset. If you click master once or twice, you'll see this mixer screen. Using the up and down arrows, you can go through all 16 MIDI channels that I've got on this sampler. Below that, you can see that there's a preset for each MIDI channel. So MIDI channel 1 has an untitled preset, number 2 split amen, so on. Okay, so the way I set up the effects was to click the master button so I get this, go to effects, and then set up. And originally it was set to preset on MIDI channel 1, which didn't do what I wanted it to do. So I changed that to master settings, click exit a few times, get back to my main screen. So where are we? So say I've got the split amen. At the moment it's going through the main bus, which I want to keep clean. So basically I'm going to go to preset manage, click edit, and then it comes to the normal edit page. I'm going to click exit and go to global, go to the next page. You'll get this little message. I'll click F6, which is master. So now I can choose where my effects are going to go. I quite like the perfect reverb, perfect room reverb, it's okay. So the way I'm going to set it up is main effects is going to have nothing on it because I want that to be the clean channel. I want sub effects to have effect A, which in this case is perfect room on it. Then I'm going to set the next effect, which will be effect B, on sub 2. And on sub 3 you can have a combination of the two, which is probably desirable. Okay, so I've chosen perfect room at 14% on sub 1. I'm going to go to the next page, which is master effect B. I'll just turn that down for a sec. And I've chosen a panning delay just because it's obvious and you can hear that it's working. And I've put that at 41%. So say I wanted a combination of the two. I would use sub 3 for that. So I'll just make it super obvious by putting it to 100% that both of them are going through, and put sub to 100% as well. Okay, and then click exit a couple of times and get back to my main screen. So now I've got amen going through the main at the moment, so that should be a dry signal, the way we set it up. So yeah, that's dry. Put it to sub 1, it should have that little bit of reverb on it, which it does. And then sub 2 should have the obvious panning delay sound, which it does. And then sub 3 should be a combination of the two, which is just totally over the top, just to show that you can mix the two effects together on a sub 3 channel. So you've got the two effects combined then. Okay, so that's how I use my effects. Cheers.